Hey guys, welcome to Ultimate Greatness, and today we have The Walking Dead. This will be Season 1, Episode 4, Part 2 in the series. And in the last episode, had to dig up a grave that had a dog's collar in it to get into a house. Chuck ended up making a decoy. Not a decoy, but ended up sacrificing himself. We didn't see him die, but he tried to sacrifice himself for the betterment of the group, so that was good on him. And we also had to shoot a little boy as well, which Kenny couldn't do it himself, so we had to help him out with that, because, you know, obviously with Duck and we couldn't have let him shoot a second kid, so we ended up doing that. That was pretty much it, what happened, and yeah, so I guess we'll move on, and yeah, we'll get back into the video, and yeah, so this is The Walking Dead Season 1, Episode 4, Part 2. Alright, here we go. Alright, so we'll look through here.
Great, needs a quarter to work.
Oh dear.
Some kind of warning? Do something like this.
No, I ain't shooting. Screw that. Okay, we need to find. What did I say? 20 sim. No, a quarter. So 25 cents. But for us, it'd be like a 20 cent coin in Australia. Because we don't have 25 cent coins. Ooh, cash register. That'll have it. Yeah, we can't have it too easy on The Walking Dead.
I should probably stick close to Kenny. It's too dangerous out here.
Okay, so we can't go that far. Okay, let's keep going. Let's newspaper machine. Ooh. There we go. Let's head back to the. Yeah, let's head back to this and look through it.
What's up with the boat?
It ain't gonna work. Hull's cracked beneath the waterline, plus someone stripped out the battery.
You can't fix it?
What the hell is that?
Fate worse than death. Abandoned, like every other place in the city.
Alright, so let's go across.
Salvageable. The Talmadge Memorial Bridge. Imagine how many people tried to escape across it when the city started to fall. Nothing but water, not a boat to be seen. The hell?
Ooh. That was the. Was that the person on the bell tower? Because the person was definitely wearing a hoodie. I think it is.
we hiding?
Someone came down from that building at the end of the street. Where'd he go? Saw him run into that newsstand.
Mm-hmm. Could be our bell ringer. How about we go find out?
It looks like him.
Did he come here looking for trouble?
Yeah, well, it seems to have a way of finding us anyways. Look, this could be the guy from the radio. The one who's been messing with us. If he is, we can put an end to it. Right now. Okay, you head up the middle of the street. I'll go around the side, cover your flank. We'll come up on him quiet. Take it by surprise.
Alright, do that.
We just want to talk to this guy.
Oh, we're gonna talk.
How did that happen? Oh shit.
No!
Clem?
Please, don't hurt him! You're not from Crawford.
Crawford? What the hell are you talking about? Kenny, don't!
Are you people?
Everyone just calm down.
I'll calm down once she tells me who the fuck she is.
Back off, asshole. The name's Molly.
Molly? I'm Lee. This is Kenny and Clementine. Not looking for any trouble.
Hi.
You guys really aren't from Crawford, are you? Everything beyond that barricade.
What the hell happened here?
You sure you want to know?
Not really.
When everything started going to shit, some people got together and sealed off that whole neighborhood. Folks willing to do anything to stay alive, stop the dead getting in. I try to avoid them.
Why?
Let's just say they have a zero tolerance policy for anyone who won't or can't live by their rules.
So how'd you know we weren't them?
Because there are no children in Crawford. Not anymore.
What do you mean, no children? Why not?
No children, no elderly, no one with an advanced medical condition. Basically, no one who might be a burden on the community. Crawford's all about the survival of the fittest. That's how they survived. While the rest of the world went to shit around them.
Jesus Christ.
Well, just the opposite, when you think about it.
That's not how our group does things.
You're not saying they actually... I mean, kids?
No. The children, they just forced to leave. Along with their parents. Left them to fend for themselves out here in the world.
Why?
Like I said, zero tolerance. Crawford got rid of anyone that couldn't pitch in, pull their own weight. The way they looked at it, those people were just a lot of useless mouths to feed. A drain on their precious resources.
How do you know all this?
Everyone in Savannah knew. What was going on inside Crawford got passed around like a ghost story. Except this one was true.
who's been ringing those bells all over town?
Yeah, that would be me.
I knew it! Lee, I knew she was the one who'd been following us! Fucking with us!
Get that finger out of my face, Grandpa, before I jam it straight up your ass. We haven't been following you. I don't even know who the hell you people are.
Calm down, Kenny. The voice on the radio was a guy, remember?
Yeah, well, whoever you are, ringing those bells this morning nearly got us all killed. Raised the dead all around us.
That's the idea, genius. It's how I get around. I ring a bell in one neighborhood to attract the local geeks towards it. Buys me some time to scavenge the areas they cleared out.
Geeks? Is that what you call them?
Yeah, you know, like at the carnival, they'll eat anything, alive or dead.
That's pretty smart, the bells.
Doesn't take much to outsmart the dead. Bunch of dumbasses. You just gotta move fast, get in and out before they start to wander back again. Look, I'm gonna ask you people again. You're not from Crawford, so who the hell are you? What are you doing here?
We're just trying to survive, same as you.
And the only way we're gonna survive is by getting on a boat and getting the hell out of here.
Yeah, good luck with that. Anyone with a boat took it out of here as soon as people started eating each other. Any that got left behind, Crawford stripped them for parts. Cars, too.
There's gotta be something.
If there was, do you think I'd still be here? I've been over every inch of this city. This whole place is picked clean.
God damn it! Fuck!
Hey, moron. You wanna keep your voice down?
Shit.
Since you're not getting on any boat, I'd advise you folks to go back to where you came from before... Great. Just great.
Isn't that the... Gunshot must have brought him back.
Isn't there another way back to the house?
Mom, is there a...
Hey, you're just gonna leave us here?
Sorry, I must have missed that part of our conversation where you became my problem.
Don't leave us here, please.
Come on, make it fast.
Come on, hurry!
Come on!
Come on, man. One good jump.
Yeah, come on. Ooh. Shit. We have to jump on the
come
bin.
On, Lee. Get your ass out of there!
All ground underneath.
God, can't get it open.
Here, use that to pry it open.
Come on. Yeah, it could work.
Please.
All right, so we're in the sewers.
Just get back to the house, okay? I'll meet you there. Shit.
All right, let's move on. Okay, what's over here? All right, go down here, I guess.
Ooh. Ain't touching that. Last thing I need is some god awful disease.
Ooh, here we go.
Come on.
It's a drainage pipe.
Okay. This has something. Oh crap. Ooh, here we go. What's this? Can we get it off? Yeah, good. Alright, can we just get it open? Yeah, good. Because, yeah, we couldn't have gone the other way because we would have got caught by the walkers. But if we can put it on here. Turn it left. I think. Not right. Yep. Alright, now out of the way. Because the walkers will be coming. Yep. Out of the way. Good work. All right, so we just have to wait it out. Chuck.
Chuck, he must have tried to hide out down here. Poor bastard. No bullets. He must have saved the last one for himself. You deserve better, old man.
R.I.P. Chuck. Oh god. Oh crap. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah, good. Thank you. God, that was intense.
No way I can pick that up on my own.
So let's go up here then.
What the hell?
The hell is this? It's a note, it's a opening to something.
What the hell? Must have been one of those old nuclear fallout bombs.
Oh, people.
Who are you?
It's all right. It's okay.
I don't want any trouble.
Neither do we. Which is why you'd do well to turn around and leave right now.
Look, I'm sorry I disturbed you folks. I'll just be going.
You can't let him leave. He's from Crawford. If he goes back there and they find out we're down here...
Are you from Crawford? Hey, don't lie to me. I'll know.
Where else can he be from? Everywhere else around here is dead.
I think you better start talking.
Came here with a small group hoping to find a boat. Just want to get out of here. How about you just let me go?
Ain't no boats around here. Crawford took everything.
Yeah, I heard.
You can't trust him, Vernon. You can't let him leave.
What do you want me to do? Shoot him in the head?
Why not? Be more of a mercy than anyone from Crawford ever showed us. Think, Vernon. What do you think they'll do if they find out we're down here?
Oh, were they in Crawford and was told to leave?
I'm sorry, friend. Can't take the risk.
I'm not from Crawford, but I saw what they did up there. It made me sick. I'm not like them, and I don't think you are either. I think you're a good man.
Keep back, or I swear I'll shoot.
I told you he's lying. He is one of them. Kill him before he kills us.
The fuck? He don't die. Oh, damn.
Who are you?
It's all right. It's okay. I don't want any trouble.
Neither do we. Which is why you'd do well to turn around and leave right now.
Look, I'm sorry I disturbed you folks. I'll just be going.
You can't let him leave. He's from Crawford. If he goes back there and they find out we're down here...
Are you from Crawford? Hey, don't lie to me. I'll know.
Where else can he be from? Everywhere else around here is dead.
I think you better start talking.
Came here with a small group hoping to find a boat. Just want to get out of here. How about you just let me go?
Ain't no boats around here. Crawford took everything.
Yeah, I heard.
You can't trust him, Vernon. You can't let him leave.
What do you want me to do? Shoot him in the head?
Why not? Be more of a mercy than anyone from Crawford ever showed us. Think, Vernon. What do you think they'll do if they find out we're down here right under their feet?
They're in Crawford, I can't.
I'm sorry, friend. Can't take the risk.
Look, don't want to do this. Let's talk, okay?
What's to talk about? You won't even tell us who you are.
My name is Lee. I'm a history professor. I don't want to die today. I don't think you want to kill me either.
Don't. Don't come any closer, or I'll shoot.
Come on. Let's just talk about this.
Vernon, what are you doing? Shoot him!
Nobody needs to get shot. Just take it easy. It's all right. It's okay.
Vernon, what the hell are you doing? Vernon!
Relax. I'm not here to hurt you.
You're really not from Crawford?
No, I'm really not.
Well, we are, or were. We got out of there when they started sealing up the place. You know, started weeding out the sick and the old, so the perfect survivor society wouldn't be threatened. No room for weakness or vulnerability in their little master race.
You don't look that old, so you're sick?
We're sick. We're all members of a cancer survivors group that used to meet here at the hospital. We're in remission. But that wasn't good enough for Crawford. They'd already rounded up five of us before the rest of us managed to hole up and hide from them down here. This old basement's been abandoned for years.
What is this? The morgue?
Yeah, irony's always high on my list when I'm looking for a place to survive. How did you find your way down here?
I told you. My group and I were up by the river looking for a boat. Now I just want to get out of here and find them again.
Well, that sewer system you came through runs all over the city. It'll take you wherever you want to go.
Those sewers are like a damn maze. Any chance you could help me find my way back?
Look, I'd like to help you, but we've all got our own problems. Two of our group are sick and need constant care, and I'm the only doctor here.
Besides, why should we help you?
Look, sorry if I scared you. I just want to get back to my people. Back to Clementine.
She's your daughter.
No. She lost her real parents.
Yeah.
Doing what I can.
You're not seriously considering going with him.
It's all right, Bree. I had a daughter, too. Lost her in the first days. I'll be damned if I'll just sit back and let that happen to someone else.
We need you here.
Don't worry. I'll be back before you know it. Let's go.
All right.
Clementine? Clem? Molly?
Oh, hey. You made it back.
Who's this?
He didn't tell you about me? Understandable, I guess. I'm the one who put that beating on him when he tried to jump me back at the river. Who's the fossil?
This is Vernon. He's a doctor. He helped me get back here after we got separated.
I think you have something that belongs to me.
Yeah.
Lee, thank God you're back.
Krista, what's wrong?
It's Omid. He's gotten worse. Much worse.
Oh, no.
Who's this?
This is Vernon. He's a doctor.
Oh, thank God.
Could you take a look at him?
You have to help us. Please.
I'll see what I can do. Take me to him.
Omid, honey. You're gonna be all right. Lee brought a doctor.
All right, let's take a look at him. I work better without an audience. I'm sure you have more things of your own to attend to.
All right, then.
Clementine. Clementine?
Alright, so I guess that was end of the video. So obviously it was a pretty good episode. Pretty good video. And part of the episode. And yeah, hopefully this continues. And yeah, I guess I'll see you in another video. So if you like the video, please like the video. And if you want more content, please subscribe. And would like to thank you all for watching. Hope to see you in another video. Thanks.